Welcome to England. Live as live can be. Honestly, definitely, I'm 110% sure that I am now live across the World Wide Web. At least I hope so anyway. Hi everybody, hello, good afternoon. There it is, the live view from my studio window looking out over the Shropshire landscape. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you super duper happy? I really, really hope so. First of all, can I apologize for the late start today? Lots of things have been going on YouTube, because of course, just in case you haven't already realized, YouTube have launched a new service today where you can live stream on your mobile phones and devices as well. In fact, on your tablet and mobile phone, you can now stream live. But it would appear that it has made some slight issues. It has created some problems for those who want to stream through their PC. So I have managed to sort it out, finally. So here we are, live as live can be. On this special day, it is a very special day today. Do you know why it is special? It is special today because it is exactly 10 years since I returned to England from my adventures in China. It's true, everyone. Yes, 10 years ago. Oh, for goodness sake. Please tell me that that hasn't frozen. Oh, my goodness. Excuse me a moment. Oh, dear. See, this is what happens when you do a live broadcast. Everything that can go wrong does go wrong, so please bear with me. I've had quite a few technical issues this afternoon, let's just say. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 do. Now hopefully that will now work. I only have 30 people watching me at the moment. That's not very good, is it? I almost feel like packing it all in. Okay, is the camera working? Let's have a look. Yes, we have success, everyone. The camera is now working. You can hopefully see me live. Here we go. It is live. Eventually, we get it up and running. As you can see, it's now 5:05. I am 1 hour late, because I have been trying to get everything working. Everything in the studio has been going crazy. And of course, YouTube haven't helped at all, because they've been making lots of changes today, because now you can stream through your mobile phone and through your tablet device as well. So lots of things going on across YouTube. And of course, those changes have made some problems. They have created some problems for me here. Oh, dear me. All I can say is I'm glad that I have a lot of patience. I'm a very patient person. Can't you tell? So here we go. It is Wednesday, February the 8th. A special day because this is the 10th anniversary of me coming back from China to England. 10 years ago today, I arrived in England after spending 4 years working in China. So I thought today we would do a special live stream. It's not a very long one. It's quite a short live stream today. So not 2 hours or 3 hours, nothing like that. So please bear with me. So it looks like we are now up and running. I have, of course, opened the live chat. You are welcome to join in with the live chat. If you wish to do so, you may. We only have 30 people watching at the moment. That's not very good, is it? That's not very encouraging at all. I think YouTube are trying their best to get rid of me. I really do think this. I really do think that YouTube is trying its best to get me to leave, because they seem to make everything so difficult for me these days. So difficult. So the live chat is up and running. Dung Kawasaki. Isn't that a make of motorbike? I think so. Hello, Dung Kawasaki. Hello and welcome to you. Where are you watching at the moment? My name is Mr. Duncan and I am broadcasting live from England. Right now, this is as live can be. Just to prove it, over there, you can see it's now 7 minutes past five in the evening here in the UK. A lot of people have asked, Mr. Duncan, can we have a look at your live view? There is the live view outside. You can see the reflection of the lights in the studio, but you can see the garden as well. So there is the live view from outside the house. Dun Kawasaki says, what is this? You mean, what is this? This is a live English stream. I teach English and I have done so for over 10 years on YouTube. Unfortunately, today things have gone slightly wrong because of all the technicalities involved with putting one of these live streams on. It's very difficult to do this, you know. Lots of work, lots of equipment. Sometimes the equipment doesn't work properly, and sometimes YouTube doesn't work very well either. So today I think it was YouTube's fault, not my fault, YouTube, because they keep making changes to their service. Yes, everyone here is learning English, Dun Kawasaki. I think we have established that now. So it's 10 years since I returned from China. Oh, do you want to see some photographs from my time in China? Would you like to see some photographs? Really? Let's have a look, shall we? Here are some photographs from my time in China. This, believe it or not, is the first ever photograph taken of me after arriving in China. And can you tell where I am? Can you see where I am? Do you know? Of course, I am standing in Tiananmen Square, and this was taken on my first day in China when I arrived there way back in 2003. So this photograph is now almost 14 years old. Now, the reason why the quality of this picture isn't so good is because it was taken off my mobile phone. I will explain why a little bit later on. So I left for China way back in 2003, and I returned on this very day in 2007. So I spent 4 years living in China. And there I am. There I am standing in front of the place, or the name of the place where I was working, a place called Baotou. And there is Baotou. What is your first impression of Baotou? What do you think Baotou is like? Baotou is a very large city, huge population, spread over many, many, many miles. It is an industrial city, mainly producing steel. And as you can see there in the distance, you can see some chimneys letting off some smoke from one of the many power stations that exist near where I used to live in China. And there I am in front of my entrance, the entrance to my school. If you can read Chinese or Mongolian, you will see that it is actually the Chinese party school. So my school, the school that I worked for, was actually situated, it was actually inside the party school, the Communist Party School. Although I didn't teach for the Bardi school. I actually taught for another school, a school that rented some classrooms within the party school. And there I am in my staff room. There it is. That was probably one of the first days that I was there teaching. And I'm sitting at my empty desk. And there I am doing what I love doing, most of all, eating. I love eating. And there I am eating some delicious Chinese food. I think that particular food that I'm eating is tantrulichi. I think that's what it is. I can't tell from the photograph, but I think that's what it is. Another photograph taken from Baotou. This is very near to where I lived. Two very famous places if you are a person who used to live in Baotou, or if you are watching in Baotou right now, you will recognize these two landmarks. On the left, you can see the Tian Wai Tian Hotel, which means sky above sky or heaven above heaven. And next to it, you can see a statue, and that is a statue of three deers, San Lu, as they call it. San Lu. Yes, I did learn some Chinese whilst living there. Another picture of Baotou that you can see in the distance, the mountains of Inner Mongolia, because I was living in a place called Inner Mongolia. Very remote, very dusty. Not very far away from the Gobi Desert, in fact. So that is where I used to live. Another photograph taken from the city of Baotou. That's where I lived between 2003 and 2007. Because today is the 10th anniversary of my return from China to England. 10 years ago today, I arrived back in England. We don't have many people watching at the moment because they probably think that I've gone away because of the technical problems. Mr. Duncan, Musab El Shazali. Hello, Musab. Welcome. Glad to see you here. Oot R says, nice to have you back, Mr. Duncan. Yes, I'm back, although I haven't really been anywhere, to be honest. I've been nowhere. I've been here all the time. So today is a special live session. I won't be here for too long. I will probably be here for another half an hour. So this is just a very short live English lesson. Mitra Panahi says, hello, Mr. Duncan. Nice to meet you again. Happy anniversary. Yes, it's true. 10 years since I arrived back here in the UK. 10 years ago today since I came back from my adventure in China. Wow. So thank you very much. Mitra says, it is my first live chat, Mr. Duncan. Well, I hope it isn't your last. I hope the technical problems haven't put you off watching. So I'm very sorry about the problems we had today. Some technical problems. Rekha Kuna says, hello, Mr. Duncan. It's so nice to see you again. Thank you very much. Thank you. We've had some problems again today, but this time it wasn't my fault. It was YouTube's fault. Yes, because they've made some changes to their live streaming. So it wasn't my fault. It was YouTube's fault. Okay? Okay. Shamba05 says, hello, Mr. Duncan. I'm watching you from El Salvador in Central America. Hello to you, and a big hello to everyone watching in El Salvador. Thank you very much. I have people watching all around the world. Can you believe? Look at all of the places where people are watching. So many places, so many countries around the world. Lee Quinn Nur says, cool room. Thank you very much for that. It is my little studio here. in England, and that is where I do everything from. I make English lessons, I make recorded English lessons, and also I do live English streams. And on my YouTube channel, there are over 300, I'm not joking, 300 English lessons for you to watch. Lucy Lou, you don't know how many things I got to make from watching this. Oh, Lucy, do you mean that my English lessons have helped you in some way? I hope so. That sounds very nice. Thank you for saying so. Mr. Duncan, I have noticed with you a few weeks ago, but I'm very happy to see you right now. Mirksan Zagros, thank you very much. Where are you watching at the moment? Thank you for joining me today. Simona Badisha says, hello, Mr. Duncan, again. I'm very happy to watch you. You are very welcome. Very welcome. And Simona Badisha says, thank you for teaching us, and I'm very happy to watch you. Thank you very much. Abdullah 60 says, why can't I understand the British accent? Oh, why can I? I don't know. I'm not sure. Maybe you need to practice your listening a little bit more. You need to listen to lots of different types of English. Thank you for teaching me freely, Mr. Duncan. That comes from Paolo De Tarzo Costa Souza. I love your name, by the way. Very nice. Thank you for joining me. Back to my photographs taken during my time in China. The place where I lived was very deserted. Can you see the buildings there in the photograph? It almost seems as if there's no one living there. And that's because there was no one living there. My school was situated very close to this area. Now, all of the buildings you can see in the photograph were new buildings. They were all built just before I arrived in 2003. But all of these buildings were empty. They were empty for a very long time, in fact. So these buildings were brand new, but no one could afford to live in them. Although, having said that, now many people live in this area, and many of those buildings you can see in the photographs are now lived in. But way back in 2003, no one lived in this area. All of these new buildings were empty. Here's another photograph giving you a similar view. As you can see, there are hardly any cars and no people, virtually no people living in that area. But please bear in mind, this was way back in 2003, this photograph was taken. So this is actually 14 years ago in Baotou. Another photograph looking the opposite way. Again, you can see how empty and quiet the area is. But it isn't anymore. Another one. Again, you can see that most of those buildings are empty. Now let's get down to the serious part, which is what I did in China. When I lived in China, I used to teach English. That was my job, and there I am teaching. In fact, this is the first ever photograph taken of me in the classroom. Now you can see on the blackboard, my writing is very large. Now the reason why my writing is so big is because that's the first thing I ever wrote on the blackboard for my students. And I was so worried that they wouldn't be able to understand or read my writing. I was worried that the writing would be too small. So what I did, I wrote it as large as I could in big capital letters. But then one of the students put their hand up and said, Mr. Duncan, you don't have to write so large. We can see what you are writing. So after that, my writing on the blackboard, was much smaller. Here is another picture. And as you can see, I have written my name in Chinese. Oh, yes, I can write my name in Chinese. In fact, let me just write it down now. There we go. I've just written my name in Chinese here, just to prove that I can do it. There it is. I can still write my name in Chinese. That says Duncan. Duncan. So Deng, like Deng Xiaoping, and Ken, like Ken Daji. So there it is. There is my name in Chinese, Deng Ken. Deng Ken. Eugene says there are no trees on the photographs. There were no trees growing in that area because all of those buildings were brand new. They were new buildings. So that's the reason why. That's the reason why. So I could write my name in Chinese. And there I am in the classroom, standing at the front of the class, holding on to my dictionary. For dear life. I don't look very happy there. I look a little bit nervous. And once again, that was taken during my first ever English class that I taught 14 years ago. Another picture. I'm sure many of you have seen this photograph because this picture was taken around about the same time in 2003. And there I am teaching in class, one of my students looking very embarrassed. And if you look at my face, I also look a little bit embarrassed as well. I was very nervous during my first class, I can tell you. And that picture was taken much later. As you can see, the handwriting on the board has changed a lot. It is much neater and much smaller. So there is another picture taken from one of my classes that I used to teach when I lived in China. Because, of course, today is the 10th anniversary of my return to England after teaching in China for 4 years. And there is a picture taken in the classroom with some of my students. I think this was 0143, I think. 0143, I think that was the class. And as you can see, most of my students in the school were girls. Here's a picture of me looking very strange with one of my co-teachers, a former student who became a teacher. And whenever we were together, we always acted very strangely and a little bit crazily. We were slightly crazy when we were together. For some reason, we used to find it very funny to say the word furniture a lot. I don't know why, but we used to say furniture to each other and then just laugh. So that is Wong Lei and myself way back in 2003. We used to have a lot of crazy times together. We were both a little bit crazy, to say the least. This is the dormitory in my school, and this is the first computer that I bought. I think I spent about maybe 600-700 yuan on this computer. It didn't work very well, but at least it managed to send emails home to my friends and relatives. So there it is, my first ever computer. Nausea Film says, Mr. Duncan, your appearance didn't change much during the years. I think I looked very young. Here is another photograph taken in my dormitory before I moved out of the school, because later I moved away from the school. But this is a picture taken in my dormitory, looking very relaxed. So that was 14 years ago. Can you believe it? That picture. That's taken 14 years ago, just after arriving in China. Here's another one, this time in front of the computer. My dormitory was very small, very tiny. And that's the reason why I moved away. I actually rented a house later. Lots of special things took place in Baotou, including the annual light show. There would always be a light show in the park, very close to where I lived, and very close to the school. Here's another picture taken during the light show. I look so happy there. I don't know why I'm wearing sunglasses, because it is nighttime in that photograph, so I don't quite know why I am wearing sunglasses. Another photograph. You might have seen this at the beginning of today's lesson. Another one taken during the light show. A very spectacular light show. Quite wonderful, in fact. This is one of the parks in Baotou. This is Yinghe Square. Yinghe Square. And within this small park, you have a lake and also lots of deer walking around as well. Lots of deer. So if you wanted to go somewhere to escape and relax, you could go and sit with the deer. And the deer were very, very tame. As you can see, this one came right up to me. Very tame deers. Now, this is interesting. This is a snow deer, a white deer. Very unusual. This is something you would see very often in Chinese parks whilst walking around. You would always see people playing games in small groups. They would all be huddled together and they would play lots of different games. Sometimes they would play card games and others would play this particular game. This is called Wei Qi. Wei Qi. It's a little bit like draughts and chess mixed together. So this is a game that lots of people in China like to play. It's called Wei Qi. And around the parks, you will see lots of people playing that particular game. Wei Qi is the name of the game. Oh, now of course we can't talk about food. We can't talk about China without talking about food. In fact, I am very hungry at the moment. So here is a picture of me sitting in KFC. In fact, at the time, there was only KFC in Baotou. There were no McDonald's, only KFC. And I used to spend a lot of time in KFC. There's another picture, just to prove it. There I am once again, eating a chicken burger with one of my friends. Now, there I am eating something that was very popular in Baotou, and especially around Inner Mongolia. It's called hot pot. Hot pot. And the hot pot was normally made with mutton. Mutton. Mutton is old sheep. Old sheep. So mutton is old sheep. And they would slice the mutton up and put it into boiling water. It was called hot pot. Hot pot. And can you see I'm wearing the same t-shirt? So there's my t-shirt many years ago in China, and here it is now. I'm wearing the same t-shirt just to prove that I haven't put any weight on over all those years. I'm still as slim as ever. So hot pot is a type of meal made with mutton, vegetables and spices. And there's another picture of me eating my hot pot. Shamba 05 asks, Mr. Duncan, do you like tofu? No, I don't like tofu. I'm not very keen on tofu, to be honest. I don't like it. Bean curd is what it's normally called. Bean curd. But I don't like it. Ugh. Not very much, to be honest. When you cook the mutton in the hot pot, it becomes very light. Yes, it changes colour. Sometimes the hot pot was nice and sometimes it wasn't so nice. Victoria, yes, you can see that I am wearing my funky t-shirt. There I am many years ago. I think this photograph was taken in maybe 2004 or 2005, I think so. Another photograph. Now, this is not taken in Baotou. This is actually taken in Beijing, during one of my trips to Beijing. And as you can see, I'm standing outside Mac and Lai. Mac and Lai is McDonald's. Back to Baotou now. This is a very well-known building in Baotou, although it doesn't look like that anymore. Mr. Duncan, I've just watched your video where you are talking about cars and motorbikes. When did you sell your motorbike? I sold my motorbike after returning to the UK. I think I sold my motorbike in around about 2010, because I had to raise some money. So I sold my motorbike. Do you know why I sold my motorbike? I sold it because I had to have some money to buy some equipment so I could make my video lessons. It's true, I'm not joking. So that's the reason why I sold my motorbike. I sold it so I could buy some equipment many, many years ago, so I could make my English lessons. It's true. Back to the photographs. So that place is called the Workers' Hall. And there is the photograph I showed you earlier. Once again, you are looking at a slightly different angle. The three deer, the symbol of Baotou, and next to it, Tian Wai Tian Hotel. So here I am out and about in one of the busy shopping areas. And this picture was taken, I think this was taken in 2005, during the Chinese New Year. Another photograph just to prove that I was there. There I am in front of the three deer and the Tian Wai Tian. J1K says, Mr. Duncan, what about Skype? I prefer Skype more than WhatsApp. I don't use Skype. I never use Skype, but I do use YouTube Live, and sometimes I use Facebook Live as well. Yes, Victoria, you are right. Now my motorbike is part of my studio. So many, many years ago, I had to sell my motorbike so I could buy some camera equipment to make my lessons. Where do you broadcast from? Right now, I am broadcasting from England. I am live in England right now. It is now 25 minutes to 6 o'clock here in the UK. And I am live to the world, apparently. Is 5:35 a.m. or p.m.? It is p.m. It is evening. Just to prove it, Here is my live outdoor camera. There it is. Oh, of course, now you can just see me. Unfortunately, because of the reflection on the glass. So, yes, it's night time now. It's not morning, it is night. Thank goodness. Some more photographs. We are working through these pictures. I hope you are not too bored. Snow time! Yes! It's time to look at some snow pictures, because the winter in Inner Mongolia is very, very harsh. It gets very cold. Very cold indeed in Baotou. In fact, the temperature gets as low as minus 20. Minus 20. That's 20 degrees below freezing, below zero. My goodness. So there is a nice picture of one of the many cycle lanes. So even though that looks like a road, it isn't a road. It is, in fact, a cycle lane. Here's another picture taken again. You can see the three deer in the background, but there is a Chinese snowman. I was very fascinated by the way in which Chinese people build their snowmen. They build them very differently to how we build them here in the West. Very different. They look very, very wide. Very wide. So there is a Chinese snowman, just in case you've always wondered what a Chinese snowman looks like. So I didn't build that, someone else did. There is my bike buried in the snow. Even though it was snowing, I still rode my bike. I still used to go out on my bicycle to ride it around, even when it was very, very cold. A picture of my school now. Let's have a look at some pictures of the school where I worked. There is a photograph of the playground. You can see the basketball nets as well. Another photograph. These are some of the classrooms at the school where I worked. Can you believe all of this is now gone? It's now gone. So all of these buildings that you see here have now been demolished. So this school no longer exists. It was demolished about 3, maybe 4 years ago. So all of the buildings you see now have been destroyed. They are gone. So these are some of the rooms in my school where I used to work. There is the staff room. That's Mr. Duncan's room, that is. Or at least it was. At least it used to be. Oh, and by the way, the bike isn't mine. That isn't my bike, just in case you're wondering. Another picture of the school, taken from high up. As you can see, there are many trees. The area where the school was very, very beautiful and scenic, as you can see. So this is actually in the school, inside the school itself. Excuse me while I drink some water. My throat is very dry. So yes, very scenic. I used to spend many hours standing on that bridge, thinking about my family and friends back home in the UK. Oh, and there I am standing by the bridge. This photograph was taken around maybe 2004, I think. So about 13 years ago, this picture was taken. Now, not everything in Baotou or China was good. Sometimes bad things happened to me. One night, after coming out of a KFC, I was actually robbed. Can you believe it? I was actually robbed by two people. Two Chinese men jumped on me and they robbed me. and they took my phone from me that was on my belt. They used a knife to cut the phone off my belt, and also they cut me as well with the knife. As you can see on my arm, you can see a small cut. So as I struggled to stop them from robbing me, they actually cut me. So that wasn't a very nice experience. So not all of my experiences in China were good ones, and there is a very clear example of one of the bad things that happened to me during my time in China. I was robbed, but fortunately it only happens once. As you can see, I'm not smiling in that photograph. I don't look very happy at all. I wonder why. Talking of bad things, here is my bike. Now, this was my brand new bike that I bought about a year after moving to China, and this was my brand new bike. But can you believe I only had that bike for 2 days? 2 days before it was stolen. Someone stole my bike, my brand new bike. I left it near the school and someone stole it. It was locked. I put a great big lock on there as well, so it was locked, but sadly it was stolen. In fact, I had many things stolen from me. Many things. Oh, look. Oh, so many beautiful memories coming back. This is my little dog that I had whilst living in Baotou, China. So whilst I was living in China, I had some company, and this is my little dog. This dog is called Tudou, which means potato. And the reason why I call my dog Potato is because I thought her head looked like a potato. So that's the reason why. So there it is, as my lovely little dog Tudou, and she was my company whilst living in China. Here's another photograph. Oh, look, it's my little dog. This particular breed of dog is called a pug. P-U-G. Pug. Pug. Very popular in China, pugs are. Another picture of little Tudou. As you can see, she is starting to grow in this photograph. Starting to grow. So she's getting larger. And there she is again. I think she's sitting on top of my refrigerator. Isn't Tudou lovely? Excuse me. Little Tudou, my little pug. Now this is Tudou. As you can see, she has grown up a little bit. So this is taken about 2 years later. And as you can see, Tudou is much larger. I must say, my little Tudou was very friendly. Very friendly. A lovely, lovely dog. And wow, it's so nice seeing these photographs again. Do you realize I haven't seen these photographs for such a long time? So there is my little Tudou. I miss her so much. I really do miss my little pug. Just before we go to the next photograph, let me just say that there is a sad part to this story. Not everything that happened to me in China was good. I was robbed. I had my bike stolen and lots of other things stolen from me. But also, can you believe it? Someone stole my little Tudou. Someone stole my dog as well. I moved to another house within the area near my school. And one evening, after letting my dog out for a little run outside my kitchen window, I looked outside and she was there. And then I went outside and she wasn't there. So for some strange reason, my dog vanished almost in front of my eyes. So I went outside to bring Tudo in and she'd gone. And I walked around for hours and hours afterwards trying to find my little dog. I couldn't find her anywhere. She just vanished. And it would appear from talking to people afterwards that she was actually stolen. So someone actually took my little dog. I wish I could say that Tudo ran away, but I did search and search and search for many hours. In fact, I searched for days afterwards, many days. I asked my neighbours to help me. I asked many people to help to search for my little Tudo, but sadly we couldn't find her. So what often happened at that time is people would just go around and take dogs. They would just go around in a car and they would just pick the dogs up and take them away and drive off. Normally they would go to another province or another town and then they would sell the dogs to someone else. So my little Tudo, from a puppy to an adult, and then stolen, sadly. Here I am out in the grasslands, something a little more cheerful now. Here I am out in the grasslands of Inner Mongolia. And as you can see, the area I was in was very flat and open. So the Mongolian flatlands or grasslands. And here I am riding a horse. This picture was taken in, I think it was taken in 2003. So this photograph is around about 14 years ago. So here I am riding a horse with my colleague Wong Lei. Both of us riding horses, not very well. Not very well. So that photograph taken 14 years ago. And there I am dressed as an emperor. Do you like that? Oh, don't I look? I think I look very smart in that. And in the background, you can see the Mongolian houses called yurts. Yurts. The Mongolian house is called a yurt. Mr. Duncan, you have very long legs. Thank you, Victoria. Yes, you can see from that first photograph that I'm very tall. A lot of people in China used to say to me, Mr. Duncan, you're very tall. We have noticed that you are very tall indeed. And yes, it's true. Thank you for noticing. Another photograph now. This time I am sitting on a camel. Okay then. So in the last picture, I was on a horse. And now I'm on a camel. And the one thing that nobody warned me about is when you get on top of a camel, you are very, very high up. I must be honest, I didn't like going on the camel. I felt a little bit nervous, to say the least. This is a photograph taken in another part of Baotou now. This is a picture taken in May 2003. And you can see the street fruit sellers. And this place is called Donghe. D-O-N-G-H-E. Donghe. Which is Chinese for East River. East River. So that's another part of Baotou. Lots of people now noticing that Mr. Duncan is very tall. Yes, I am very, very tall. It's true. Here I am sitting in the park. This is taken in Donghe. And there is a bit of a tradition in maybe in other Asian countries as well. But lots of people like to go and sit in the park during the afternoon, especially at the weekend. especially old people. There were lots of old people sitting around normally during the daytime in the park. And there I am, look at me, keeping fit and healthy there with my friend Wong Lei. We are exercising, and you might notice that there are a few people watching. Can you see that? Whenever I walked around Baotou, I would always get crowds of people following me, or at least two or three people following me. So you can see there on that photograph, there are actually people watching because they are very curious. Because for many people, they might not have seen a foreigner before. So perhaps for some, I was the first foreigner that they'd seen. Of course, in China, they call the foreigner Lao Wai, which means old outsider. Lao Wai. So lots of people used to shout Lao Wai to me in the street when I was walking around. Ah, some more people sitting around now and standing around playing a game. I wonder what they are playing. Maybe they are playing cards, or perhaps they are playing Wei Qi. Who knows? Here I am now at Wong Lei's grandmother's house. And what are we doing there? I think we are making some Chinese dumplings. Jiaozi. I think we are making some Chinese dumplings there called Jiaozi. Here is another photograph. There is me, as you can see, looking very, very moody. I think that's my cool look. And there's Wong Lei. And at the back, you can see a young lady in the photograph as well. She is the owner of my school. She is the daughter of the owner of my school. And we were out together getting something to eat. I look very serious on that photograph. Here is one of my favorite photographs taken during my time in China. This is me looking at a very large fish. That isn't a real fish, don't worry. That isn't a real fish. It was on a photograph, on a large poster. But I quite like that photograph. It always makes me laugh whenever I see it. Here's another photograph taken in one of the back alleys of Donghe. Baotou is very, very dusty. That's one of the things I noticed when I first went to Baotou. I noticed that it was very dusty in Baotou. During the springtime, you get very strong winds, and those winds can get very, very strong. And sometimes the wind would blow from the Gobi Desert, and it would carry all the sand, and then the sand would all land in Baotou. So you would have these amazing sandstorms that would come from nowhere. Incredible. And you didn't want to be outside when they came. The sky would go orange, and then suddenly you would hear this strange noise. And you knew that you had to get indoors before the sandstorm came. Very scary. So there I am in Baotou. That photograph taken about 14 years ago. So there I am, 14 years ago, well back, way back in 2003. Here we are again. This is me and Wong Lei. We were hanging around, where were we? It looks like Yinghe Square again. And can you see we've got the same trousers on? We didn't intend to have the same trousers, but we just accidentally had them on. We had the same trousers because Wong Lei went to buy some, and then a few days later I went to buy some. Then when we saw each other, we realized we had the same trousers. So that was rather embarrassing. Oh, look at this. A very serious photograph here. Can you see what's happening here? Can you guess what was going on when this photograph was taken? This was taken during the SARS outbreak. Who remembers SARS? Yes. So just after arriving in Baotou, SARS broke out across China. And lots of people in the street were wearing masks to protect themselves. In fact, everywhere in Baotou closed down. So all of the food stalls, many of the restaurants, they all closed. So there was nowhere to eat. And that went on for around about nearly three months that went on for. And unfortunately, I couldn't work because all of the schools closed down. So every single school in Baotou closed. In fact, every single school in China closed during the SARS outbreak. Who remembers SARS? But I stayed. I decided to stay in China, even though most of the foreigners had gone. So many foreigners, in fact, almost all of the foreigners had left. So they all got on planes and flew back to their own country. So I was virtually the only foreigner left in Baotou during the SARS period. So I didn't run away. I stayed there. And my school couldn't believe it. So during my SARS vacation, that's what I call it, by the way, SARS. During my SARS vacation, we used to just go out and walk around the streets. But can I just say now, we weren't really wearing those masks. We actually bought them from a shop and put them on and then just took some photographs. So can I just say we weren't really wearing the masks? This photograph was taken during the SARS outbreak. Now, we were told that we shouldn't eat any food that's been taken from outside. But can you see what we are doing there? We are actually eating food that has been taken from outside. Yes, very naughty. So there we are eating food from outside, even though we were told not to. That's because we are very naughty. And there I am. I'm not sure what I'm eating there. It looks like some sort of bread. And can you see I'm also using chopsticks? I'm using chopsticks there, yes. A lot of people ask, Mr. Duncan, can you use chopsticks? Yes, I can. Of course, chopsticks in Chinese is quites. Quites. Chopsticks in Chinese. Quites. Oh, now earlier on we mentioned motorbikes. Now I almost bought a motorbike whilst I was in China, but I didn't in the end. I changed my mind. So I did think about buying a motorbike, but then I changed my mind. So I didn't do it in the end. I didn't. Oh goodness me, here we go again. Here we are with our matching trousers. And just to prove that sometimes even men wear the same clothes by accident. Now sometimes women do that, don't they? Women sometimes, they go to parties wearing the same clothing. So here I am with Wong Lei doing the same thing. Here we are wearing the same trousers by accident. Earlier I mentioned that I lived in the school. A little later I actually moved out of the school because the dormitory that I was staying in was very, very small, a very small dormitory. So I actually moved out. I went to live in a small apartment. And this is the area that I was living in. In fact, you can see my flat. You can see the place that I was staying in on the right hand side of the screen. And there is my local shop. The local shop that I used to go to buy my groceries. All of the things that I needed, especially milk. I used to drink a lot of milk. I used to drink loads of milk when I lived in China. Milk and bread. Of course, the only problem with going to the local shop is they knew who I was and they knew where I lived. Unfortunately, lots of people found out about this. And so people would go to the shop and say, "Do you know where the foreigner lives?" And they would tell them. And then people would just come and knock on my door and ask for English lessons. So that was slightly annoying, that that the local shop near where I lived, they used to tell everyone where I lived. They used to say, "Oh yes, he lives in that block over there, that number." So that was slightly annoying. So I used to get lots of people coming around saying, "Mr. Duncan, can you please teach us English? Do you know where this is? Can anyone tell me where this is?" Now, this is not Baotou. This is somewhere else. But where is it? Do you know where it is? Let's have a look at the live chat for a few moments. Mr. Duncan, "I am really glad to see you today," says Asma Shelb. "You are welcome. No problem." Paolo de Tarso says, "I've loved this live class, but now I have to leave." Oh, I'm very sorry to hear that, Paolo. Bye, Paolo. See you again. See you again soon, I hope. "How many streams will there be, Mr. Duncan?" Don't forget, I will be here again on Friday. So I will be here on Friday. So this isn't my usual live stream. This is a special live stream today because it's the 10th anniversary of returning to England. 10 years ago today, I came back to England from China. So that's the reason why I am talking all about China today. That's the reason why I am doing it. Lady Manira says, "I live in the United States, in Orlando, Florida." Hello to you and welcome. A big hello to you. A big howdy. "Mr. Duncan, when is your next live teaching?" asks Musab. Musab, I will be here on Friday. So this Friday, 2 p.m. UK time. This Friday, 2 p.m. UK time. So I will be back again. Don't worry. Simona says, "Nice photographs, Mr. Duncan. Nice memories. Thank you for sharing them with us." So where is this place? Where is it? I will tell you, this is Beijing. But of course, Beijing doesn't look like this anymore. It looks very different. And here I am in Beijing. I'm sure a lot of people recognize this place. Here I am standing in Tiananmen Square. I think this was taken in October 2005. So this photograph is around about 12 years old. So this is 12 years ago. There I am standing in Tiananmen Square. It looks like I'm pointing at the man on the bicycle, but I'm not. I don't know who he is. And there is Tiananmen Square again. You don't normally see this view. You don't normally see this view of Tiananmen Square. You normally see this view. So this is another view. In fact, can I tell you now, Tiananmen Square is very, very large. It's huge. Very big. A very large place. You can almost get lost in Tiananmen Square. As you can see, I am standing in front of a sign which is announcing the 2008 Olympic Games. In fact, if you look very closely, you can see the clock is counting down. So if I can see clearly, it says 1,409 days before the Olympic Games. So this photograph was taken in October 2005. Around 3 years before the Olympics came to China. Another picture now. There I am standing. It looks like I'm standing alone. Not many people around. Another place. As you can see, some more deserted houses. These are the houses that I showed you earlier. Now, all of these houses were built new, but no one could afford to live in them, so they stayed empty for a very long time. And there I am on my lovely blue bike. Needless to say, my blue bike eventually was stolen. So even my blue bike got stolen eventually. So first of all, my red bike got stolen, and then my blue bike got stolen. I did have many things stolen from me during my time in China. Here I am in my apartment. This is the first apartment that I moved to after moving out of the school. It was actually quite large. It had two bedrooms, a very small kitchen, and a very, very tiny bathroom. There is my lovely bathroom. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Look at that wonderful bathroom. Isn't it nice? Wow. Look at the luxury that I lived in. And there is my kitchen. Can you believe it? That is actually my kitchen. There is nowhere to cook in the kitchen. So this is the house that I used to live in during my time in China. And here is the computer. And you might notice that it's the same computer that you saw earlier, the same one. It only cost me around about 700 yuan, but it lasted for quite a long time. Talking of money, some people ask, Mr. Duncan, can you show us some Chinese money? So here is some money, some Chinese money. At the top, you can see 100 yuan. And underneath, you can see 10 yuan. 10 yuan. But of course, everyone likes the 100 yuan notes very much. We all like them. So I used to teach lots of people. Here are some adults that I used to teach. Now, these lovely, lovely people were working for the communist government. So actually, they were members of the Communist Party. They were actually members of the local government authority. And I used to have a lot of contact with the local authority in Baotou. They knew me very well. In fact, I used to do lots of work for them. So here I am teaching some of the government workers. Here I am now with some of my students. This photograph was taken way back in 2003, just after arriving at the school. Oh, dear me. I look so young. So there I am talking to some of my students. And here I am with some of my students. Now, these were some of the graduates that were leaving during my first year in 2003. So all of these people were leaving just after I arrived. And if you look very carefully, can you see the guy at the front? Can you see what he's doing? He's actually flipping his finger. Can you see it? Let me just zoom in. Can you see? Look, can you see what he's doing there? He's flipping the finger. He's flipping the finger. Yes, he is. He's flipping. Very naughty. So, here I am outside one of the training centres that me and my school opened. And as you can see, my picture was actually on the sign. Nobody told me that my photograph was going to be used on the sign. I was a little bit shocked when I realized that everyone in Bao Tou would be seeing my face above the training center. So I was a little bit surprised by that. Here is the photograph that you saw at the beginning, because now we have come full circle. That is it. I hope you have enjoyed those photographs. A little trip down memory lane. Now, I will be back on Friday. Yes, a lot of people are saying, Mr. Duncan, we can't believe it. We can't believe you will be back on Friday. Yes, I am here on Friday, live on Friday from 2 p.m. UK time. So back on Friday, I will be with you. I hope you will join me then. I am going to leave you in a moment. I hope you don't mind. It is now 10 past six, you see, in the evening. 10 past six. For all of those who are asking about learning English, you can check my YouTube channel. There are 300 videos, in fact more than 300, so many English teaching videos on my YouTube channel. There is the address, youtube.com Duncan in China. That is the address. Just before I go, let's have a look at some of the live chat here. Simona says, yes, really, live stream on Friday. That is awesome. Yes, I will be back on Friday, 2 p.m. UK time, definitely. Lou Baby says, what an interesting, amazing experience you had there, Mr. Duncan. Awesome. Yes, I must say I did enjoy my time in China. It was an amazing time. In fact, there are so many stories that I could tell you about my time in China. A lot of my friends say, Mr. Duncan, you should write a book about your time in China. Maybe I might. Who knows? So I am about to leave you. I hope this wasn't too boring. I am very sorry about the technical problems. Can I just say it wasn't my fault? It was actually YouTube's problem, because they have made some changes to the site. And those changes happened today. So I'm very sorry about the problems that we had earlier. Ray Kakuna says, Mr. Duncan, it was a very nice live stream. I am so happy that we'll see you on Friday. Yes, I will be here on Friday with my normal Friday live English stream from 2 p.m. UK time. In fact, I'm going to write it down. So I will be here on Friday, 2 p.m. And that is, of course, UK time, just to make it very clear. There it is. I will be with you on Friday at 2 p.m. UK time. I hope you will join me then. I hope you will see me on Friday. If not, don't worry. I am here every single Friday, every Friday, every week. You can catch me live as live can be on YouTube. I am going now. I hope you've enjoyed this. What a lovely live stream. Thanks from Yemen, says Miss Kulud. You are very welcome. You are very welcome. Marcos Silva is watching in Brazil. Thank you, Marcos, for watching, and I will see you on Friday as live can be. Andrew Malaychikov says, we haven't seen Pedro's pictures, he promised. He's in a t-shirt there. Really? I haven't seen Pedro's pictures at all, I must be honest. Unless it's on my phone. Let's have a look, shall we? Maybe it's on my mobile phone. No, there's nothing there. Perhaps we will get to see them on Friday. Who knows? Thanks for sharing your memories, Mr. Duncan. It was very nice to see the photos and very useful for our comprehensive skills to listen to you. You are very welcome. And that's the reason why I do this, you see. The reason why I do this is because it gives you a chance to listen to someone speak English for a very long time, over a long period of time. So that's the reason why I do it. I am going now. It is coming up to 16 minutes past 6 o'clock in the evening on a Wednesday. I hope you have a super duper rest of the week. Have a great Wednesday, what's left of it. Have a good Thursday and a super duper Friday as well. Don't forget, I will be back on Friday at 2 p.m. UK time. Friday, 2 p.m. UK time. Just a couple of days away. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of the English language saying thanks a lot. Bye, Ariel. Bye, Victoria. Bye, Eugene. Bye, Pedro. See you all later. And of course, enjoy English. Enjoy whatever you are doing. And of course, until next time, ta-ta for now, and zaijian.